Last week, the 2011 Collegiate National Team came to the Triangle area of North Carolina. Let's take a look at some of the action. The Collegiate National Team's visit began with the Prospect Classic. Game one was in beautiful downtown Durham at the Durham Bulls Athletic Park. Florida's Brian Johnson got things going for the Collegiates, hitting a single up the middle to allow Eric Weiss of Texas and Dominique Ficicello of Arkansas to score the first two runs of the game. Josh Elander then hits one over the center fielder Albert Almora's head, giving him a triple and two RBIs, letting the Collegiates take a 5-0 lead. The Collegiates ended up taking the game 12-1 and sweeping the 18U national team with an 8-1 victory in Cary. Next up for the Collegiate National Team was the 38th Annual Friendship Series versus the Japanese Collegiate All-Stars. Matt Reynolds of Arkansas hit a blooper into left field, allowing Oral Roberts' Chris Elder to score, giving the U.S. a 1-0 lead in the bottom of the second. But the Japanese resurged, getting a 2-1 lead until Hotaka Yamakawa came up to the plate with bases loaded, hitting a first-pitch fastball over the Blue Monster, increasing the Japanese lead to 6-1. The United States then scored two runs, making it 6-3, until Tyler Naquin of Texas A&M hit this opposite field single, making it 6-4. Dominique Ficicello then hits it into the gap, letting Eric Weiss and Tyler Naquin score, making it a 6-6 ball game. Chris Elder hits a single past the center fielder, allowing Ficicello to score from first, letting the United States win this game 7-6. After a rainy 4th of July, the clubs agreed to play 2 on the 5th. Game 2 was held in Cary, North Carolina at the USA Baseball National Training Complex at 11 a.m. After 5.5 innings of no-run baseball, Japan took a 1-0 lead in the bottom of the 6th. The United States responded with this Chris Elder single, making it a tied ball game. The next batter, Matt Reynolds, singled, advancing Elder to third with men at the corners with no outs. Reynolds gets into this pickle as he attempts to steal second, distracting the infield to allow Elder to steal home. Five more runs would score before the inning was over, and the final score was 8-2 in the favor of Team USA. Game 3 took place later that day at the Durham Bulls Athletic Park. Japan once again took an early 3-1 lead. But Brian Johnson steps up to the plate after the 7th inning stretch, knocking this one into the Herald Sun home run patio, making it 3-2. Tyler Naquin hits a wall ball double, making it 3-3. Josh Elander gets walked, then Dominique Ficicello steps up to the plate, hitting it up the middle, letting the U.S. take a 4-3 lead. Marcus Stroman of Duke University gets the save, and the United States clinches the series versus Japan with the final score of 4-3.
Oh, from day one, we've got along just fine. I mean, we have fun. We're playing games down in the clubhouse. We're singing songs, dancing together. We've gelled, you know, as good as you could hope for.
I mean, honestly, it's probably the best accomplishment of my life. It's been a blast playing with these guys and just being able to come out here and represent my country. It's been more than I could ask for.
For USABaseball.com, I'm TJ Scholl.